Hey friends, you may know that IP address ranges are mapped to specific countries or regions, and since companies often need to provide different services based on location, Azure Maps IP to location service enables you to use a customer's IP address to determine where that customer is located. And Julie is here to show us how that works today on Azure Friday. Hey folks, I'm Scott Hanselman, and it's another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Julie Kohler, who's going to talk to me more about Azure Maps. You may have seen some of our other great episodes on Azure Maps. In this one, we're going to see how we can take an IP address or range and turn it into a location.
That's right. So today, there's a lot of scenarios that need this support, and I'm going to talk about even ourselves. Mm. So in Azure Maps, there's certain locations that we don't support today, but we're working on it. Mm-hmm. And so we might need to block content. And so we will look at the IP address of the caller mm-hmm. and block accordingly. There's other examples of things like, say, Netflix or a streaming service. I'm sure you've noticed sometimes if you're traveling, you'll get different content for Netflix based on the country that you're in. Mm-hmm. And so if you need to change content based on somebody's location, this would allow you to do that just by simply passing in their IP address, getting the country, and then knowing what to display to that user.
So you say getting the country. I'm getting back the ISO, is it a two-character country code?
Yes, it's the two-character country code.
Okay.
We are looking to add more in the future, but for today, this is a good start and a good place to begin understanding the location of the caller.
Okay. So in this case, I'm not trying to figure out their location to the meter. This is not geolocating with a GPS. This is literally figuring out the boundaries of the country that they're in and then tailoring content to give them a better experience.
Yeah. It can also be used to understand where your users are calling from for your service. So you could look at that later and say, you know, we see most of our users are in this region or this country, and knowing that maybe you want to make better content or support that country more than you've been doing in the past.
Is it fair to ask how accurate is it? Is it like 99% accurate, or is there times when it's just totally inaccurate?
We get our results back from IANA, so it's the same accuracy that you would get back from IANA.
Okay, cool. And you got a demo?
I do. So I'll do a couple of calls. So this one is actually our IP or my IP address.
Oh, okay. Is it a IPv4 or IPv6?
I don't actually know.
That one looks like a pretty, that's an IPv6. So that's that's interesting. That tells me right away that you support both, you know, 4-dot and 6-dot.
So I believe we do support both of those.
Cool.
So I got back that my country code is US.
Okay. That is true.
I'll show you another example. So this is some from India.
An IP address that we know is assigned in India.
Yeah, I checked for a range and what you typically get back, and so I picked one from the range in India just to check that.
That makes sense.
And then this one is Canadian. And you get back Canada.
Okay, so that code and these ISO codes, in this case you're getting back the two-digit, I don't know if it's a digit, if it's a letter, but the two-letter country code, I could use that for lots of things. Like I used to work in banking and we would have translation of different websites, so if someone shows up in Canada, I'd know I'd need to show them French and English, while I might not have that need in the U.S., but also currency, right?
Yeah.
So I could apply, I'm starting to think about how all the things I could apply this to. I could think about showing a currency if someone is traveling in another country, mm-hmm. but their machine is an American machine, but I'm on the road in Denmark.
Yeah.
All kinds of stuff.
Or showing offers that are valid for the country that they're currently in when they're traveling.
So for advertising. Mm-hmm. And again, it doesn't take you all the way down to their city or their zip code. This is really just for tailoring things to the country.
Yep, this is for country for today.
And this is built into Azure Maps APIs. It's just one of the APIs available in the toolbox. Mm-hmm. And is it charged the same way?
It's based on transaction. It's a little bit cheaper than some of our other calls because we know that people might make this commonly. And so you can take a look at our pricing page and see the number of transactions and the pricing there.
And where do people go to sign up for Azure Maps subscription keys?
Yep, that would be through your Azure portal. Mm-hmm. And so when you already have an existing Azure subscription, you can get your Azure Maps subscription key there.
Okay, so when I go into the portal and I say create a new thing, I usually create VMs and app services. I would go and create an Azure Maps kind of instance.
Yeah, you create a new resource,
a new Azure Maps resource. Okay, so Azure Maps appears as a resource, and then I can go and use it anywhere in any of my other resources.
Yes.
Okay, and as you've seen, we've been doing this with Postman. These are just straightforward REST calls. This one is a pretty straightforward GET, and the results come back as JSON.
Yeah, and very quickly.
Fantastic, and this is available today.
It's available today.
All right. One more resource to you in Azure Maps is the ability to turn IP addresses into locations, in this case, down to the country level. And I'm learning all about it today on Azure Friday.